Dr. Richard Maponya has been described as a legendary black businessman. Black Business Council President Sandy Luzungu has described the late business giant as an inspiration and someone who lived for Africa. Dr. Maponya is credited as a creative thinker and a generous man who worked in the interest of his community. The well-known Maponya Mall forms part of a long and inspirational legacy for the man dubbed the grandfather of black business. Zungu has urged young entrepreneurs to emulate Maponya.
Maponya went into business when the government of the day was a regime which was hostile to his interests.
Yes.
But he was not allowed to own licenses, but he pushed on. So young people of today need to also say, let's be single-minded when I start businesses. Yes, let's trust on government to be there for us, but let's not solely depend on government. Let's build our own businesses, and through blood, sweat, and tears, we shall triumph.
According to family spokesperson Mandla Sibego, Dr. Maponya was deeply worried about the state of the economy. He was also concerned about the high levels of youth unemployment and felt that people needed to get a different work ethic.
He felt it was unnecessary that you have such a big restless population of young people. These are supposed to be the hope for South Africa, who are not in the mainstream economy, and he felt like that was not good and not healthy for the economy. So with the decline of the economy, he was really concerned and felt that we should find a way in skilling young people as much as possible.
Businessman turned politician Herman Mashaba says Dr. Maponya was a template to any aspiring business person who yearned for success. He described him as a man who never feared failure and someone who believed in the education of black South Africans.
Dr. Maponya's success in business didn't happen by luck. It happened because the man believed in hard work. I think I was listening earlier on this morning, one of his recent interviews, where he's actually making it clear that his retirement will only happen the day when God decides to take him. I mean, that is really what determines one's success. He's a man who actually believed in very strong family, stable family environment. You know, as we grew up, we didn't just really know about Richard. We knew about Richard and Marina Maponya. It was a family unit that created this empire that the family is enjoying today.
Ironically, the man who contributed immensely to the transformation of the economy died at a time when the country's economy is facing many hurdles. But one thing that will survive the economic turmoil is his legacy. Balentlem Tetwa, SABC News, Johannesburg.